don't repeat this type of mistakes again. These all are silly mistakes, but you will waste your time. And for the next section, you will not get sufficient time to write that 5-mark questions answer, or maybe a 3-mark questions answer. So please, you, if you are going to write, you have to write in all these 2 questions. That means anyone, upper or lower, any one question you can be selected, and you can write that answer. Then after, you can attend next question. Okay. Next one is a write any 3 points of difference between economic growth and economic development. If in the question paper, in question already written, write any 3 points, then only you have to write 3 points, 4 points. Then also you have to write 4 points. But if this sentence has not written, write any 3 points of, this word has not written 3 points, and only written write difference between economic growth and economic development, then you have to write 6 points. How many points? 6 points you have to write. If already they have written write 3 points, then it's okay. You have to write 4 points, then over. But if they have not mentioned that 3 point, 4 point, 6 point, like that, then you have to write 6 points for 3 marks, 10 points for 5 marks. Okay. Next one is state the importance of human development index. Importance of human development index. This is answer already we have done in our previous class video. This point, this importance are only tax economic factors, but also include social welfare. Next one is HDI indicates the policy makers and economic development is only a tool, but it can be estimate objective of only human behavior. Next one is true progress equal to, that means what, economic progress as well as plus science progress. Let's see. Then after, HDI is functional. HDI is what? Functional. Developing countries get an idea as to where there is a scope for development. Last one is HDI is progressive in its approach. These points are written. 5-mark question. Explain an improvement in the physical quality of life index as an compare or indicator of economic development. Next one is explain the cause of the inflation in detail. We have these 2 questions. That means we have to attend any one. If you are going to attend, explain an improvement in the physical quality of life index as an indicator of economic development. For this, we have to write first means of the physical quality of life index. First, then after we have to write. Then after we have to write that, draw the chart. In that chart, there's all 3 factors also given. These are knowledge, life expectancy, and fund mortality rates. Because of PQLI, not HDI. So you remember this thing, which is the third, because 2 may be same, education and life expectancy, but third one is changed. So the third one is related to infant mortality rate. First one is literacy rate. First one is what? Life expectancy, literacy rate, and infant mortality rate. We have to write this all 3 meaning after the chart. We can draw the chart. On the top we can write indicators of PQLI. Determinants of PQLI. Then we can write this all 3. First one is what? First one is life expectancy, literacy rate, infant mortality rate, then their meaning is required. Thereafter you have to, because of it is 5-mark question. So explain the improvement in the physical quality of life index as an indicator of economic development. So we have to write after that. There's all points, important aspects. Then how we can measure formulation. And in the last important, the importance of physical quality of life index. Favorable points. Then after our answer will over. But few students have written very short answer. Okay, explain the causes of inflation in detail. Causes of inflation. Why inflation is occurring? These have three main causes. So from which point we have to start our answer for 5 marks? From introduction. We have to start from introduction. Listen, whenever we are going to write any answer for 5 marks, first of all, we have to start from introduction. That means meaning. Inflation means constant increase in the price of the goods and services in all sectors of the economy. That is known as inflation. Then if we have any type of definition, we have to write definition also with it. Then we have to write this all. There's all points which are related to all head points. So we have to draw the chart. In beginning, we have to write cause of the inflation. Then we have to part. There's three. First one part is the increase in the demand. Second one part is the increase in the cost of the production. Then third one is other reason. In the increase in the demand, we have again sub point. This sub point also we have to write in the chart. But only 6 students have drawn the chart. Sony Pooja, Pankaj, and I forgot Mitali. No. Mehak, and this 6 students have written drawn the chart. I have written their names. So these students have only have drawn the chart. What about others? So you have to draw the chart. Then you have to complete this answer. It is attractive. It is a very correct way to write for 5 marks. So next time you write it, so it will, you will be habitual to write this answer, that answer in this way. How we present our answer. You know very well that answer. But if your presentation is not perfect, then you will not get full out of full marks. I'm trying to give all information. By this all information, you can get full out of full marks. This type of information I'm going to pass out to you. So please, students, follow this all. I can give instructions, but it's depend to you how you are following or not. Increase in demand. Next one is the increase in the cost of production. That's the part also you have to write. Increase in supply of money, increase in public expenditure, overpopulation. Then second one point is increase in the cost of production. It has not sub point, but supply shock and cost push inflation. It is meaning we have to write in this. Then other reasons. Other reasons also four. These all points we have to write. In the last, we have to write conclusion. If you have not written conclusion, 0.5 marks will be deducted from your answer book. So please you remember this thing and complete it. You can estimate what marks you got. Already I had given marks yesterday. So please you follow these instructions and don't repeat these mistakes. I hope you all will get good marks in the next exam. Thank you. Thank you very much. We'll meet again in the next period, in the next week. Thank you very much. Be happy. And please follow instructions. Thank you.